Only thing I don't want is them going valiant on my potential stored calm mind. I think I'm gonna go for stored power here, as they do go valiant and I catch them off guard. This valiant is dead, and now my Latias would straight up win. How's it going, everyone? So, a tiering survey was just announced on Smogon forums, where they asked the player base how do they feel about the current meta game. If they think it is good or not, how do they feel about certain Pokemons, if they are banworthy or not, like Gouging Fire, King Gambit, Roaring Moon, Volcarona, all the top dogs in the tier. So I saw the tiering survey and I was surprised to see a Pokemon not mentioned in that survey, and that is Latias. I personally had the opinion that Latias is pretty good in the meta because of its ability to just sweep and turn Terra Poison, not get poison, and then just beat stall if they are not running any Annihilator or Dark stuff. So yeah, I thought it's going to be in there, but Garganacle was mentioned, which is in the same tier as Latias, that is UUBAL, but Latias wasn't. Now, I have not used Latias that much in the meta. I've used it a couple of times here and there, but not extensively enough to form a solid opinion. So I decided I'm gonna do that here today. I'm using this bold Latias Hazard stack team. I picked it up from forums. It is made by Kadiro. I made a little bit of changes to suit my own playstyle, and yeah, we're just gonna jump right in and see if Latias is really the top dog or not. And my first opponent has the Samurott Hazard stack offensive team, I would say. Wait, yo, this looks like the Finchinator team, but the Samurott version of it. I saw this RMT on forums. Yeah, I don't know what the set was. I know like these sets, but I don't know what Samurott set is. As a lead though, I feel like Samurott into Samurott could be good. So I'm gonna do that. I am Adam and Samurott, they led Landorus. Is it worth going Razor Shell on this for damage? Alright, can also just go Lando and get rocks up. I mean, rocks are pretty good. I guess I can Razor Shell once. Oh, faster. Alright, makes sense. Samurott Hisui comes out. They have a faster Landorus. Quite interesting. I'm just gonna go my own Landorus because it does get that Intimidate off on them. And they click Ceaseless Edge, so I can get my rocks up pretty easily. Even if they click Razor Shell next, they got a crit, so that was not a knockout, but unfortunately my rocks will not be there to stay. Now Dragapult cannot knock them out in U-turn, unfortunately. And I don't know if they would have Sacred Sword or not, but I guess we're gonna do this and just go for that Ceaseless Edge to put them in range. They go Landorus, I get my spikes up too. They don't have spin or anything like that. I'm just gonna click Razor Shell in case they get their rocks up. It would have basically been a rocks and a spike on both sides, to be honest. They go for U-turn. Unfortunate that I don't get rocks up, but it is what it is. We are going to deal with it. This is Terra Dragon, and it's funny that they go into it. I mean, I believe their variant has Encore, so it's gonna be hard to set up. I won't be able to set up just like that. I don't think Dragon Darts knock them out. It won't. I think I would go Latias and just calm mind up once. Yeah, they do quiver. I'm gonna Terra and then calm mind once again. They probably Terra themselves and go for the dragon type move. Nope, they quiver dance. Oh, I just do. The only thing I don't want is them going valiant on my potential stored calm mind. I think I'm gonna go for stored power here, as they do go valiant and I catch them off guard. This valiant is dead, and now my Latias would straight up win. Yeah, it would win. It would just straight up win. I'm pretty sure about that. I don't think they have anything that can knock this out. Ceaseless Edge though. I think I'd go for a couple more. knock off, knock my leftovers off, and I will just go for recover here. Aqua Cutter, they're going for the crits, I see. Sucks that Aqua Cutter can crit, but I hope it won't. I'm just gonna go Aura Spear now, it's not doing enough. Yep, no crit, Thumb Rod gone. It may not be a sweep, I feel like, because they still have their Terra, but it's gonna be a good game, I would say. No way Sucker Punch knocks me from this range, but they probably have Terra Ghost on this. I'm not sure if they would do that. What if they plus 2 Terra Ghost? Would that Sucker Punch knock me out? No, it won't. So I'm gonna go for Recover here. Yep, they do Terra Ghost. They go for Kowtow. I am out of the Sucker Punch range right now, so I'm just gonna Stored Power here. Knock the King Gambit out. Third knockout in Latias's bank account. Ooh, and they just forfeit. First game, Latias sweeps the shit out of them. Now, how do they feel about this? So here we have a pretty balanced looking team with a Core Chain Cinderace, so I don't think it'd be wise to get spikes up, but if they do get spikes with their own Tinglu up, then I can do that. As a lead, I think Zapdos is pretty good against my team, and I don't like that. I think Zapdos is pretty good here. If I lead Dragapult and get the burn, Zapdos into Samurott, if they have Thunderbolt, I'm dead. If they have Volt Switch, I'm not dead. Do I need Dragapult for anything else? I don't think so. I don't think I need Dragapult for anything else. So it'd be better if I just burn them, because I do take a Hurricane and just lower them in range. I could also just start with Slowking, but I think Dragapult is overall a better lead, as they do lead Zapdos. Should I really do that? That's the question. Do planned it, but it's just that Hurricane confusions on Slowking are hard, but I guess I would do that if I do get confused, I would say, you know. So I think I'll just go Slowking for now. They might Thunder Wave this too, so that could be something. Getting a T-Spike up would be really nice in this game. For Roaring Moon, Ogre Pond, Tinglu, even Deoxys. Yeah, just let Dragapult, because it matches up well against Tinglu lead, because I can U-turn against Ogre Pond, even against Cinderace. So that's why that was the preferred lead. I'm gonna go for a T-Spike first, as they Volt Switch out into Tinglu, I believe. I would assume it's going to be Tinglu. It is Tinglu, yes. My T-Spike did not go up, unfortunately. I don't think going Landros is the play. I keep Landros healthy for Roaring Moon. I'd go Samurott. They go for Rock, so I don't have to fear Code Change, to be honest. I would just go for a knock on Zapdos. Yeah, so it's vulnerable to rocks now, which is really good, to be fair. I can just go Slowking on the Volt Switch or Thunder Wave if they decide to do that. Volt Switch it is going to be. Tinglu comes in. Nope, Roaring Moon it is going to be. That's great. That's great, actually. Because I can go my Landorus. They are booster attack, which is kind of annoying. Adamant. Or just a normal attacking set. Either way. I wouldn't beat them if I don't U-turn out here. If they basically if they DD right now and I get rocks up, then my whole team will lose to them, so I'm gonna U-turn out as they go Zapdos. No para on me, that's good. That's really good. I think I would go Dragapult. As much as I wanted rocks, I think I would have lost if they DD'd there. They now don't have their booster attack, so I can be more free with my moves. I'm just gonna go for Dragon Darts twice as they go Tinglu. That's fine, I can U-turn out. U-turn. Into my Samurott, definitely click going Samurott here as they go for Ruination. it's gonna go for a ceaseless edge. It's kind of free, and getting a T spike up is going to be very important. Imagine that T spike was up. This game would have been different. I'm telling you, Roaring Moon would have been poisoned. Dingle would have been poisoned unless they decide to do something with Cinderace. But it just changes the momentum of the game. Right now, I am kind of backwards in the game. Right now, I would say they disconnected. But it's not bad, because that Latias sweep, this game is on. All I gotta do is lower this Tinglu, and that single spike is gonna help me do that. Because they are making a lot of switches between Zapdos and Tinglu. Zapdos comes out, so yeah, this spike is going to stay. I got a crit too, no para, that's great. I'm gonna once again go Slowking. They can roost if they want. I get that T spike up. They have 30 seconds left, 20 seconds left. They reconnected. Okay. Let's see what they click. It's going to be Roost. So I get that huge D spike up. Yep, they go for Roost again. Great. I can go for a nice Sludge Bomb, I would say. On a potential Roaring Moon or even a Tinglu. I mean, it's fine. Just thought if they... That's great, actually. Now, if they want a code change, I'm gonna take their Cinderace away from them. Yep. Oh no, they changed the type. Okay, that's on me. That's on me. That was stupid. They changed the type. I forgot about that. Yeah, totally forgot the fact that they changed their type. Fireball shouldn't do much, so I can actually go for Sludge Bombs here. Ooh, they taunt me. Perfect. Cinderace. Ah, you gotta be kidding me, man. You gotta be kidding me there. Tinglu comes out, damage is damage, obviously. I believe they would go for Rock Earthquake here. I could go Lando. Samurott is decent too, it's just that Earthquake may or may not knock me out. Zapdos takes Rocks, so I think I can go for the Razor Shell freely. I wish this got poisoned. Yeah, if I had clicked Sludge Bomb there instead of Surf, this would have been different, to be fair. This does a lot too. I guess I'd go somewhere. I don't have any reason to go Landorus because... okay. Because of the fact that... Rocks are already up on their side because the code changed. They go Zapdos, take that Rocks, huge Rocks. Get the para on me, unfortunately. I go Slowking, absorb these spikes. And click Surf on the Tinglu coming in. Or even Cinderace, maybe. I hope I get this Surf off. All I want to do is put this Tinglu in range. They go Roaring Moon. That's better. Damage on this is very important too. Those. I just realized I click Surf and not. What is called? Sludge Bomb. So I'd go Landorus here. My defensive core being paralyzed is kind of annoying, but I just go for U-turn here. If they go Zapdos, they take another Rocks and. They get in range of basically Dragon Darts from my Dragapult, which is huge. I think I would burn. I would click, yeah, burn this Tinglu so I can damage this more. And I don't have to worry about going Samurott too, because Earthquake now won't knock Samurott out. The Zapdos is still low, which is huge for me. I get a ceaseless edge up, the same on both sides, and this Zapdos gets knocked out. Yeah, a spike and Stealth Rock on both sides, huge to be honest. All these four Pokemons take damage, except Cinderace, but they can't really do anything about it because the code changed already and has it the same. Pokerpon it is going to be. Now I don't want them to set up, so I'm gonna click Ceaseless Edge. If they wanna attack, they can attack. But That's why I did click Seedless Edge. Knew they were gonna do something about it, and I can always just go Dragapult. I'd sack Landorus. Even if they click Horn Leech, it doesn't matter. I can just go Dragapult and knock them out using Dragon Darts. It also hits Stingluh. If they could come in, that's great. Stingluh is gone. Dragapult is faster than everything. It can U-turn on Roaring Moon, burn the Roaring Moon even. Ogerpon probably dies to Spike and Stealth Rock. I think so. And Deoxys comes in, I see. I'd keep Samurott for Echo Jet later. I think I would go Slowking as it is the best sack I have. They go for Ice Beam. I don't want the Roaring Moon setting up on me, that's why I'm just gonna Chili out. Yeah. I'm just gonna Chili out. This may not be a Latias sweep, but this game looks in my favor. Well, anything can happen, obviously, but it looks good. Maybe I should have gone King Gambit. Ooh, they have Taunt. I see. Well, this is my sack. If they want to attack, I'll let them. Besides, Sludge Bomb hits everything. Cinderace. If I get this off, this is dead. Great. Now, Roaring Moon is the problem. Roaring Moon is a huge problem. I think I would Terra Fairy my King Gambit and just attack them. I'm gonna go Samurott as a mid ground. They click knock, that's fine. Gonna go for Seizeless Edge, I guess. They can knock me out. That is completely fine. They have not Terra'd their Pokemons. I think I still just go King Gambit and Terra Fairy and click Terra Blast and I win. Because no move will knock me out. Even if they Terra Flying, yep, I resist that. Not resist, take that EQ easily. I can Ogerpon dies to hazards and I don't think this has any one move that can knock me out. Maybe Psycho Boost because they're Life Orb, but I can still just go. Yeah, this is dead. Besides, I can still just Sucker Punch them, technically. Ah! I just misclick. I meant to click Sucker Punch. I can't believe I just misclicked. Lol. But I go Latias and just set up, I guess, just for fun, you know? Latias, it's the Latias feature. Yeah, they might taunt me though. Let's just go for a spear and finish this. They die to Life Orb anyways. Three turns, they die to Life Orb. I wanted to click Sucker Punch there, but I misclicked. And now they have disconnected. I don't believe they're coming back. Regardless, this game is over, so I'm just gonna start a new one. Alright, we have a Pelipper lead team. Well, against these kind of teams, Slowking is my favorite lead. Favorite choice of lead against Sun and Rain. Well, in Sun, I guess I would might lead Landorus before, but just look at this T spike. It goes such a long way. They have Thunder, but it wouldn't do that much. I can Chili out. As they go Hoopa, get poisoned, huge. Just huge. And I can just go Dragapult and U-turn out here. Probably using the AV set. I don't think Scarf. Okay, they just give me their Hoopa. Great. Well, this game also has Latias sweep potential because Latias completely blocks Bereskuda. I'm gonna go Samurott as a mid ground. If they go Ogerpon, it gets poisoned. They go Pelipper. That means I get a huge. I think Seedless Edge goes a long way. They Hurricane. I would just knock their Damp Rock off. Or just take them out. Pelipper gone. They don't have rain anymore. That is huge. poison, a spike. I'd keep Landros for Zamazenta because of the psychics. I think here I would just go for Aquajet for damage, rain boosted Aquajet. Liquidation, that is fine. I can go Latias. And to be honest, I win. I'd win. Yeah, I just win with this. Ooh, they are not banned. I didn't realize that because of the poison damage, but they are not banded. Ooh. I would have to recover here. Yes. Alright. Huge. Huge, huge, huge. Ogre Pond is still a threat, but I naturally resist both of it. It's a stab move, so I'm just gonna go for a combine once more. Oh, they have Player of Well. It's a recover angle with a Terra Poison. I just hope they don't click Ivy Cudgel right now. Okay, great. Yeah, awesome. Ivy Cudgel won't knock me out. I think I would go for recover once so that rain ends and I can go for stored power now, because I stay out of range of anything. Zamazenta and Zapdos, I stay out of range of that. Well, this is another sort of a Latias sweep. I don't know if I would be able to knock these two Pokemons out. If this is specs, then no, wait, I'm faster. Yeah, this game is over. I can just store power. I don't even need to set up, bro. Thunder, they are going for the para. I'm gonna recover once more. Hurricane, stored power. Yeah, I don't even need more calm minds. I just win, because even if they Terra Steel or Terra Dark, I just have Aura Sphere to knock them out. And this Zamazenta is not gonna do anything to my Latias. No, never, never. Latias is just so insanely bulky. It's just insane. You know, it's so insanely bulky. It's just insane. As I said, they thought Latias is not a problem. I am going to prove them wrong. So once again, my opponent has this Glimmora Deoxys kind of squad that I've seen a lot on high ladder, to be honest. Just gouging pretty much the similar team. I've seen it a lot. I don't know the sets or anything like that, but I think it's Breaking Swipe, Gouging Fire. Either way, as a lead, I mean, Samurott's kind of nice, but it gets burned by Dragapult. I guess regardless, I think Samurott is pretty good as a lead. As they lead Deoxys, so I do get to go for a Ceaseless Edge. They could superpower me, but I don't know that, so I really don't plan to predict it. They go for Rocks. I get my Spike up. They are Sash. I'm just gonna Jet, because I don't want them superpowering me in case they have it. Ogre Pond comes out. Now this is a threat. I can go Dragapult though. I think Dragapult's my play. I don't think they would SD or anything. They click Power Web, but missed, unfortunately. Regardless, I think I'm just gonna go for that Will-O-Wisp burn on them. They would knock me off, I believe. Nope, they just go for Play Rough. Makes sense. That Play Rough still did a lot. Are they like adamant or something? After burn? Come on. Nope. Damn, that's jolly damage after burn. That's kind of insane. Well, either way, I can just U-turn out and go my Landorus, give them Rocky Helmet if they click Play Rough or Power Whip, anything like that. They go for SD on me, unfortunately. Oh boy, they just went SD on me, didn't they? I guess Dragapult would survive the Ivy Cudgel. Yeah, I did, so I can just go for Hex now. And Ogre Pond's dead. Good thing they didn't attack my Landorus. I get to keep it healthy for Gouging Fire. About Latias sweep, I mean, it is possible, it may not be possible. But here I'm just gonna risk the speed tie and go for dragon darts. I hit, they did not turn into fairy or anything, and I get this knockout pretty easily. This game is still not over because that Pokemon is a huge threat and can do anything anytime, to be honest. I'm just gonna click dragon darts. They can spin, it's fine. I mean, at this point a single spike doesn't really matter. They go for earth power. I'm gonna go slow king just to absorb this T spike and just go for surf as they go for meteor beam, and they missed, looks like. Yeah, wow, that is very unfortunate. They missed their thing. What was the move? Flare up first. No, they missed their power whip and then this. Very annoying. Definitely very annoying. I think I would go Landorus as the rapid spin, especially because I can just Terra Water and go for that Psychic on them. If they turn Terra Poison or anything like that, that'd be great too. I hope that knocked it out. I hope that knocked it out, but I'm gonna go Latias because they don't seem to have anything that can deal with this guy. I'm just gonna go for a Calm Mind once. They have knockoff, recover, charging fire comes out. Gonna go for Calm Mind once again. They might attack, they might not attack. They go for DD, stored power. I mean, if they lock themselves into outrage or anything like that, yep, that stored power is gonna do a lot. And they have to, I guess, click breaking swipe. That doesn't even knock me out, and I win with just aqua jetting the Great Tusk. Even if they knock this thing out, yeah, this game is over. Latias did get that single knockout, but I would say it was forced by me because I don't think I needed to set up with Latias. I would have won regardless. Grass spam. Once again, huge Latias potential this game. They could have Encore Hawlucha, yes. That's the only problem. Sort of problem, I would say. I would lead with Dragapult, yes. As they go this guy, I can just simply burn this. I don't care if they knock me off. A burn on this is gonna go long way. U-turn out as they go Volcarona. Probably have Giga Drain on this, and I can still Aqua Jet this. Question is, do I want to? I think I would go Latias. I don't know if they have Bug Buzz or not, but I would Calm Mind in case they set up. I'm gonna Terra, definitely. Yeah, they do have Bug Buzz. All right. I'm gonna attack in case they go Hawlucha and I get them. Please, Oko? Gladly. Ooh, look at that. And this game might just be over. I'm not sure how much this Ogre Pond would do. I'm gonna go for Stored Power once as the SD. Makes sense. I'm keeping this because it wins. I'm gonna go Landorus. I don't need this for anything else because the Rillaboom is burned. Ivy Cudgel does huge damage. I'll try to get rocks up as they go this. I can psychic in case they want to spin or anything like that. I don't know, why would you switch? I guess you thought I'm like faster than Ogre Pond. Maybe Scarf or something like that. That's kind of pointless to think that. And once again, I can go Latias and just set up. And they won't be able to do anything to me. They can knock my leftovers off, sure. I'd go for Calm Mind again. Rillaboom comes out. I'm gonna recover once as they knock off again. And I'd go for one more Calm Mind just cuz, and then I would win. Yeah, stored power this. This game is over. This game is Jover. You didn't even do anything. You can fear dance all you want. Maybe Ogre Pond. Not sure how much this would do. Nah. Nah, nothing. Oh, never mind. I lied. That did a lot, actually. Do they really think they can knock me out in Ice Spinner or Rapid Spin or Knock Off? Let's just say they are max attack on this Tusk. Let's just say they're adamant too. Ice Spinner does 20 to 24, Rapid Spin does 13. If they're jolly. Okay, Ice Spinner can knock me out. Ice Spinner can knock me out. How much did. Was that faster against Rillaboom? Monkey, right? Nope, I was not. I wanna save this. It's just that if they're max attack, Ice Spinner would knock this out. Is it? I can save this. It's just that I don't think it would do anything. Nah, I would just try to recover. I don't think it would do. Yeah, it wouldn't have done anything really. Samurott, I believe, should take a headlong rush from a max attack Tusk. And I just go Samurott, click Razor Shell as they go for spin. So I get rid of Tusk. I can just Aqua Jet this. Now comes Raging Bolt, the huge problem. Or this guy. I think I would go for Ceaseless Edge. No way this knocks me out. Yep. And I actually want this to knock me out because, oh, I get a Ceaseless Edge off on this guy. That's huge. Yeah. The game's over this round. I mean, the Ogre Pawn was Terra, so it's not. I don't think I could have done anything. Latias was gonna die there, so. But Palutena, Volcarona, and Ogre Pawn, three knockouts in Latias's account. That's huge. Once again, I mean, it's just not even a doubt anymore. It's just certain that Latias is gonna get knockouts. All you have to do is just play, get the right opportunity and play well against those Encore users. Know when they are gonna go into a Pokemon that can Encore you, because two games I've just set up on Volcarona and just click the store power on and predicted Encore switching, because you know when you don't want most boosts. You don't have to be greedy. Don't go greedy with Latias, get two boosts and start attacking. If they have something that can stop that Latias sweep, then you would win. Of course, you have to be smart, but this Pokemon is insane. It has insane potential. And that is what I've showed you this whole game video. Is it on the radar for some action, or at least some such opinions of taking opinion of players? I would say yes. In my opinion, I think it should get that opportunity. It should be on the radar. But yeah, if it is not, I mean, it's just better for us because we can use Latias and get those sweeps. You can get those sweeps. And if you want to use this team, it will be in the description. Obviously, you can find it on the original RMT of the player that made this team. That is, I think their Smogon username is Kadiro. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. But yeah, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like it and also subscribe to the channel. And let me know if you want to see me use any of the new Pokemons in videos. I love to use them, and I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.